Some days, I wonder.
Sweet weapon you got.
Tell you something. Just
come here. Don't recognize me? Or are you allergic to making money? Listen, Pilgrim. We can make a killing, you and me. You just need to get me some beets, radishes, parsnips.
There he is. Grab him, Ed. He's a murderer.
What? Julian, Luke's been poisoned. From the water you sold him, Bevan says.
What? But I don't sell water.
Liar. Luke told me he got it from you. Whatever's in it has him ranting and raving now.
You're sure he didn't blame me after he started ranting?
I wouldn't call it proof, but he was just trying to rope me into some shady deal.
All I need to know. You're done, Julian.
Well, wait a minute. Do you have proof?
Of course. The water came in a bottle. Luke got that water in one of your bottles. When I tell Carl about this, you'll hang!
Bevan, wait! I swear, I don't even sell water, damn it!
If you're lying, Julian, you're fucking toast!
Someone's been stealing our water.
Wait, so then, if you're not selling water, how'd someone get a hold of one of your bottles?
Knowing that shithead Luke, he probably stole it. That would be like him. Even if he did, my water's pure as melted snowflakes.
You sure? How do you store it?
I buy bottled.
There's no way it could become contaminated.
Not a chance. My supplier, Marco, always has clean water.
So, maybe it's revenge.
For what? Everyone loves me. Never had an enemy in my life. Wait a second. Wait. Shit. Except maybe Marco. That bastard. Come to think of it, he's got an axe to grind for me. It was a long time ago. Never mind. Listen, he lives above an old shop on the west end of Villador on Houndfield Lane. I traded him a few kilos of my finest flour for the water. Prove he poisoned it and half my flour is yours. Can you do that for me?
I guess I could check it out.
And there's one more thing. I'm a little embarrassed. Hans might also have a bottle of this water.
I thought you weren't selling it.
I'm not, except, well, to Hans, and can you go warn him? He's also on Hamfield, a few buildings down.
Something's fishy about this, Julian. Look, you better be telling the truth, otherwise it'll be hard to help you.
You're a pilgrim, aren't you?
That's right. Do you hang people for that, too?
I just wanted to say that I was rooting for you.
Uh-huh. Thanks for standing up for me.
What? But I didn't... Ah, I get it. Sarcasm. Look, it's not that easy to go against the crowd.
Sure.
I know people are scared of pilgrims sometimes, but... Shit. You survived outside the walls. It had to be something.
Find something you like in the bazaar?
Barney's.
Hey, Hangman. How's the neck?
Very funny.
Let me tell you something. If I were you, then I'd have wished for them to end me. Would you rather have needless deaths on your conscience?
I wish you didn't hang the innocent here.
Well, it all worked out, didn't it, Pilgrim? You didn't kill anyone, and you're free. Win-win.
Who is Barney?
Everyone knows Barney here.
I don't. Tell me.
Well, I wouldn't bother yourself about Barney. He doesn't like nosy people. Liable to piss him off if he finds out. Hey, you don't want that kind of trouble.
Well, now I definitely want to know more.
Okay. He's Sophie's younger brother. Some say he's crazy, but he's a pillar of the bazaar. The PKs are afraid of him, and they should be. Barney is no one to fuck with.
Been 11 years since the chemical bombings almost killed everyone in the city. Swear to God, it's the first...
You look familiar.
Yeah, the guy who almost got hanged.
Why worry? You're standing here, aren't you?
Excuse me?
Look, we had no choice. If you had turned like we thought you were gonna, it would have been a massacre.
I see. It was a risky situation. I get it.
So? We good?
We're good.
PK and civilian alike. You're new here, aren't you? You'll see. This place is full of secrets. Most of them you don't want to uncover.
How are we supposed to make that work?
Circumstance. Always knew it.
Don't remember you here, asshole. You're mine! Jump!
Hans? Hans, you there? Hans?
What the hell?
Stop! Don't drink that water!
Water? This isn't water. Oh, that moron must have taken the wrong bottle again. Forget his own head if it weren't stuck on his shoulders.
And what did you mean by the wrong bottle?
He always takes a little rocket fuel with him when he goes hunting. But the booze is right here. That means he's got water.
Where is he?
And what business is that of yours?
The water he got from Julian. It might be contaminated.
He's hunting at this... the military tower, a few hundred meters west of here. Unless he's at the courts.
I'll go to the tower. You check the courts, fast.
Wait, wait! Take the booze with you, in case he's already drunk some of the water. I bet what's in this bottle will kill whatever's in that one.
Hans?
You old fool.
Hans? Hans, are you Hans?
What do you want?
Did you drink any of that water?
Goddamn right I did. Tasted like piss.
Ah, shit. That may have been poison, Hans.
One sip, then I spat the shit right out. Must have mixed up the bottles again. Whatever.
Wait, whatever? Are you usually this calm about being poisoned?
Who gives a shit? Not my wife, I bet. Don't think she loves me anymore.
It's your booze. Take it. Your wife said chug. Drink it already.
Bullshit.
What?
My wife said that. My Anna.
She thinks the alcohol's strong enough to burn the poison out of your system.
Ha! My woman. So she loves me after all, despite her bitching and moaning. And they say romance is dead. Here, for making my day. And maybe saving my life.
Look, you need any help getting back?
Nah, I'm good. Me and this bottle of booze still got some work to do.
How's it been, kid? Got a taste for city life yet?
I've been here and there.
You know, the best parties always happen in the center. And that's where we're going. I have a plan for how to get there. I'll tell you everything on the spot. Meet me on the roof, near the main metro station. Great. Another water thief. Just what I need. Between thieves and infected, I'll be out of business soon.
I'm here because a guy named Julian claims you sold him poisoned water.
I didn't poison anything. All right?
Julian claims otherwise.
Sure. Listen to the guy who sold me flour mixed with plaster. If you're not the thief, how are you with infected? I need to get rid of those things that are down there. If not, I'm done here. Poison water or not.
Okay, I'll get rid of the infected, and you tell me what happened. Deal?
Sure. Deal. Kid.
All right, okay, you're safe. Now, what's the story with the water?
Wait. So you really are one of those fucked up pilgrims.
Like, fucked up?
Now we're safe. Gotta be a fucking criminal. Or pretty damn fucked up to drag your ass hundreds of miles through a world full of virals. Fucked up in a good way, of course.
So, what about the water?
There ain't nothing wrong with my water.
A man at the bazaar was poisoned. And you'll be blamed if he dies.
Damn it. Okay. It was an accident. Okay? An accident. It's because of these goddamn thieves.
Thieves?
They're always stealing my water. I can't take it anymore. So, I decided to set the trap.
Do you deliberately poison the water to kill the bandits?
Not quite. At least, I didn't mean to. A while ago, I killed this viral that came crawling in here. And the fucker fell straight into a tub. The whole tub fucking ruined. Then I got this idea. Why don't I teach these bastards a lesson? So I filled some bottles with the zombie water, sent them out where they'd be easy to see. They were never supposed to make it into the bazaar. Guess I was sauced up and accidentally sold a few bottles to Julian. Look, I'll give you all the flour I got. I'll even throw something extra. Just don't tell anybody. I'd be ruined.
They'll blame Julian and he'll hang.
Don't you worry about Julian. A weasel like him will find a way to weasel out of it. And if not, then that's one weasel less in the world. So, we got a deal?
Just be honest and tell your story to the bazaar. It was an accident.
You nuts! No one would buy even a drop of water from me ever again!
I won't let Julian hang for something he didn't do.
Fuck Julian. I got my own skin to save. So that's a story you ain't going to tell.
Well, I can see you, motherfucker. How you like me now, asshole? Hey there, jackass!
Thank you.
What's going on?
Bevan's husband is dead. Julian's been accused of murdering him by poisoning his water.
Aiden, please, tell them it wasn't me.
Julian is innocent. A viral fell into a supplier's storage tub. The guy drunkenly sold Julian contaminated water. It wasn't a murder.
You'd swear to that before the Bizarre Council?
Yeah.
Where's that supplier? He's going to stand trial in-
Marco is dead. I killed him.
And my job here is done.
It's okay. I forgive you. That scum Marco got what he deserved. Thank you, Aiden. Half of my flour is yours.
Yeah, the flour mixed with plaster?
Huh? No. Where'd you hear that? Oh, yeah, so once, but, you know, it...
Now keep the plaster. Just pay me and we'll be even.
All right. I'll tell Bevan what happened.
I keep telling everyone we should be getting ready for winter.
Hakon.
You're a better climber than one crazy girl I used to know. She was something. She even wanted to climb the tallest building in the city, the VNC Tower.
Was she one of your wives?
Almost. Too hot-tempered, even for my tastes.
And what about this passage to the center?
Right. Look, from this roof you can clearly see the Peacekeeper's base.
So the PK run the city?
They sure think they do. That's what they need the uniforms and ranks for. They tattoo them. They're fucking obsessed with hierarchy. But they don't control the city. At least not all of it.
Who controls the rest?
The Colonel. The Renegades. Well, you won't meet them here. For now.
Wait, you brought me here to take a look at the Peacekeepers?
The PK are your ticket to the center. I told you the only way to get there is through the metro tunnels. I'll go inside and draw their attention away from the platform. Then you enter the Metro Technical Station. There's an airlock there. We'll take it together to the central loop.
We can't just ask them to let me through?
No chance. Right now, each new face they see belongs to a suspect in their commander's murder. They know me. I trade with them sometimes. I deliver lamps from the girls, or goods from dark zones. There might be a few infected there. Nothing a pilgrim can't handle, though. When you get to the main station, let me know. Now you better get some sleep. You'll head out at night, when there's less infected in the tunnels.
Huh? God. There's a creature I haven't seen before.
What does it look like?
Not a big one. Extremely fast.
Probably a bolter. You can find some interesting stuff on them. But catching one requires serious hunting skills. Now is not the best time for this, Aiden. Head for the tunnels.
I'm in the tunnel.
Okay. Now watch out for the infected. There might be a few, or a few dozen. I'm already in the PK base. I'll throw a UV flare through the vent, and you'll see how to get to the main station.
Yeah. Hack on. I got to the flare.
Look around. The technical tunnel to the main station should be well lit. I've already lured the guards upstairs. I'll chat them up while you get inside.
Hakon, I'm inside.
5 packs. Think about it, and I'll be right back.
I'm on the platform.
Open the airlock. I'll be there in a second.
Damn.
Hey, what are you doing here?
Where did he come from?
He was wandering through the tunnels. Fucking bizarre riffraff.
More like a renegade spy.
Doesn't look like a renegade.
He's awake. What were you doing at our base?
I'm only trying to get to the city center.
The center? The tunnel's gonna be closed until you hand over Lucas's killers. Bizarre scum.
How is it that you lot saw nothing, heard nothing, and you managed to forget about the ban on passage? Maybe we'll start punishing you by cutting off your hands. That would improve your memory, huh? What were you doing 4 days ago?
I'm a pilgrim. 4 days ago, I was 100 kilometers away.
Enough, Anderson. We need the truth, and you won't get it through coercion.
But Commander Lucas always
said... Lucas is dead, and now I'm in command. You've read the reports. A pilgrim appeared in the bazaar yesterday. Looks like he's not lying. Leave us, Sergeant. I want to talk to him alone. Where did you come from?
From Crossdale River.
That's over 1,500 kilometers from here.
It's actually more than 2,000. The freeway bridge has collapsed. There are no straight paths.
And you've managed to make it so far away. Impressive. What's it like out there these days?
When was the last time you were out of the city?
About 15 years ago.
And then there are that many fewer survivors, and that many more infected.
Stands to reason. Most people endure living in this hellhole because what's out there has got to be so much worse. My wife and I lived in England. I had 2 sisters, 2 brothers. Haven't heard from them for 10 years.
Where did they live?
In and around London.
From what I've been told, London doesn't exist. There may be 4 settlements left on the entire island.
Fucking hell.
Why would anyone think I killed your commander?
You tried to escape to the Central Loop 4 days after the murder. Besides, if I were Carl, I'd hire a stranger to kill Lucas too. It's the cleanest way.
Well, I don't know who Carl is.
Oh, you'll find out soon enough. Carl keeps both hands on the steering wheel. He's a faux sanctimonious prick who's turning the entire bazaar against us, even though we protect them.
What's it like outside the walls? You never know where danger's gonna come from. Always new territories, new threats.
And you came here to take shelter?
I came here because I'm looking for someone. And a lot of people are said to have survived in Villador.
You're looking for someone. Maybe I can help you, but not for free.
I'm used to trading. What do you need?
No nonsense. That's good. The tunnel will be closed until I find our commander's murderer, Commander Lucas. His body was found in the bazaar, horribly mutilated. The people of the bazaar aren't making this easy. They're proud and loyal. They refuse to turn anyone in. But command has lost its patience. I have orders from the top, Pilgrim. If the inhabitants of Old Villador continue to revolt, our army will come here and burn the bazaar to the ground. Now, I'd rather avoid that.
What do you need from me?
Lucas had a weapon. A rare set of brass knuckles called the Lazarus. This is the key to finding the killer. If you learn anything about the Lazarus, tell me, and I will most certainly return the favor. It's worth a lot, and we didn't find it on his body. I think someone from the bazaar may have appropriated it.
And why should I work with you? You attacked me and accused me of murder with no proof whatsoever.
Our mistake. You're clearly not the murderer.
Why can't you investigate on your own? I hardly know anyone here.
That's exactly why you can help me. Nobody will talk to us. To them, we're occupiers. The fact that we clear the streets of the infected and catch criminals doesn't matter. What matters is that we eat their food and drink their water. But you, you're a pilgrim. There are many ways you can help people. And you're from the outside. They can trust you.
They tried to kill me.
Nah, look. We are your only chance. If you want to get to the center, that is. So, will you help me?
So if I find that weapon, you'll let me through to the center?
It's not that easy. Villador suffered much. First, it was isolated from the outside world because of infection. Then the walls became its salvation. But people here learned not to trust easily. I won't open the passage until I've caught the killer. But if you can find the Lazarus, I'll remember that. You'll be the first one through once justice is done.
Sounds as if I have no other choice. I'll try.
Look around. Ask people. And don't come back empty-handed. Good luck.
Caught and questioned.
Good. They didn't kill you.
You must help us.
Meet me outside.
Otherwise, there will be a rebellion.
Help us in the investigation. We'll help you with the bandits.
I told you already. Nobody in the bazaar had anything to do with Lucas's death.
Then why won't you let us search your homes, huh? If everyone is so innocent, then there'd be nothing to hide.
Keep your brutes away from our homes, Anderson.
So you're hiding someone. Time is running out, Carl. You don't hand over the killer, we'll raise your precious bazaar to the ground.
Sow the wind and reap the whirlwind, Anderson.
Don't bite off more than you can chew, old man.
Aiden, come on. I'm on the roof next to the metro.